Vivian Fuchs. Sir Vivian Ernest Fuchs FRS, February 11, 1908, November 11, 1999, was an English explorer whose expeditionary team completed the first overland crossing of Antarctica in 1958. Biography. Fuchs was the son of the German emigrant Ernst Fuchs from the Jena area and of his British wife Violet Watson. He was born in 1908 in Freshwater, Isle of Wight, and attended Brighton College and St. John's College, Cambridge. He was educated as a geologist, and considered the profession a means of pursuing his interest in the outdoors. He was a member of the Sedgwick Club at Cambridge. His first expedition was to Greenland in 1929 with his tutor James Wordy. After graduation in 1930, he traveled with the Cambridge University expedition to study the geology of East African lakes with respect to climate fluctuation. Next, he joined anthropologist Louis Leakey on an expedition to Olduvai Gorge. In 1933, Fuchs married his cousin, Joyce Connell. A world traveler in her own right, Joyce accompanied Vivian on his expedition to Lake Rudolph, now Lake Turkana, in 1934. The findings from this expedition, in which two of their companions were lost, brought Fuchs his PhD from Cambridge in 1937. In February 1936, his daughter Hilary was born. Fuchs organized an expedition to investigate the Lake Rukwa Basin in southern Tanzania in 1937. He returned in 1938 to find that his second daughter, Rosalind, had severe cerebral palsy. Rosalind died in 1945. His son, Peter, was born in 1940. At the age of 30, he enrolled in the Territorial Army and was dispatched to the Gold Coast from 1942 to July 1943. He returned home and was posted to London at 2nd Army Headquarters in a civil affairs position. The 2nd Army was transferred to Portsmouth for the D-Day landings, and Fuchs eventually reached Germany in time to see the release of prisoners from the Belsen concentration camp. He governed the Plan district in Schleswig-Holstein until October 1946, when he was discharged from military service with the rank of major. Fuchs was involved with the Falkland Islands Dependencies Survey, now the British Antarctic Survey, beginning in 1947, when he applied for a geologist position. The organization's goal was to promote Britain's claims to Antarctica, and secondarily to support scientific research. In 1950, Fuchs was asked to develop the new London Scientific Bureau of the Survey, to plan research in the Antarctic and support research publication. He would eventually become director of the Falkland Islands Dependencies Survey, from 1958, after his return from the successful Antarctic expedition, until 1973. He became a fellow of the Royal Society in 1974. His wife died in Oxford in 1990 of a heart attack, aged 83. The next year, he married Eleanor Honeywill, his former personal assistant at the British Antarctic Survey, in Kensington and Chelsea, London. Sir Vivian Fuchs died in Cambridge on November 11, 1999, aged 91. The Commonwealth Transantarctic Expedition. Fuchs is best known as the leader of the Commonwealth Transantarctic Expedition, a Commonwealth-sponsored expedition that completed the first overland crossing of Antarctica. Planning for the expedition began in 1953, and envisioned the use of snowcat tractors to cross the continent in 100 days, starting at the Weddell Sea, ending at the Ross Sea, and crossing the South Pole. Fuchs and his party arrived in Antarctica in January 1957 after camp had been set up. The party departed from Shackleton Base on November 24, 1957. During the trek, a variety of scientific data were collected from seismic soundings and gravimetric readings. Scientists established the thickness of ice at the pole, and the existence of a landmass beneath the ice. On March 2, 1958, Fuchs and company completed the 100-day trip by reaching Scott Base, having traveled 2,158 miles. In 1958, he was knighted by Queen Elizabeth II. He co-wrote, with Sir Edmund Hillary, The Crossing of Antarctica. In 1959, he was awarded the Hans Egede Medal by the Royal Danish Geographical Society. Fuchs Medal. The Fuchs Medal was created in 1973 for outstanding devotion to the British Antarctic Survey's interests, beyond the call of normal duty, by men or women who are or were members of the survey, or closely connected with its work. The medal is awarded to one or two people per year for their contribution to the British Antarctic Survey.